My name is Kelly Mulville, and I'm out here in the vineyard at Paicines Ranch. And this is an interesting project that Sally and I have been working on for about 5 years or so now. And I want to tell you why it's interesting. I actually got into wine growing after working with livestock producers for a while. And so this, because of that experience, this vineyard and what I learned in that, this vineyard is designed in part to be accessible to livestock, in particular sheep, at any time of the year. And so there's a lot of things that make that unique because we can do that. So the initial way that I got into this was just modifying an existing vineyard with electric wires so that they couldn't get into the fruit zone. The thing about sheep is that they really do like grape leaves. And so if you have them in there during the growing season of the vines, they will eat the vines down. So the problem with that is, though, is when we really need them in the vineyards, because we get a lot of vegetation, cover crops and things like that growing late in the spring after the vines have leafed out. And so having them in there at that time is really beneficial. So when I tried that out as a trial, it ended up we got a lot of other benefits from that as well. And so the next step then was, okay, if we're modifying existing vineyards that were never designed for grazing animals, what if we just design one for grazing animals? What would that look like? How would it function? And how do we create that and make it work? And so we're in the midst of that right now, trying to get all those elements together to make this a working system. And one of the great things about getting that together, about creating this, is, as I mentioned just a little while ago, is these kind of unanticipated benefits we had. So in addition to being able to do all of what would normally be, say, weeding in a normal conventional or even organic or biodynamic vineyard, people are usually concerned about weeds and growth on the floor of the vineyard. The sheep take care of all of that by grazing it. So rather than having a tractor using fossil fuel creating compaction, we are using living organisms to do that work for us. And what we're really after now is mimicking nature, because that's how nature functions. Nature doesn't send a bunch of tractors out onto the prairie to take care of the vegetation. It has bison and elk, and same thing in savannah in Africa. There's animals that are doing this. And so we were just bringing that concept into the vineyard. And the way that we did this is that we raised the vines up. And if you can see these vines around me here, they're quite a bit taller than in a normal vineyard. In a normal vineyard, they'd be this section here would be right down here, which is just about mouth level for a sheep. So what we've done is bring this up. It's a very simple idea. Grapevine's natural habitat is to grow on a tree. So in spite of the fact that some people look at this and say, oh my God, how can you do that with a grapevine? Well, this is its natural habitat. And so these guys are happy to be up here. This is where they belong. So we're training these guys taller. That means that a sheep, even if a sheep is standing on its hind legs, it can't reach this. And so we don't have to use the electric wires that I did in the initial setup. And then a number of benefits are coming out of that. One is that because we're higher, we're less prone to frost. Cold air tends to settle lower. And so having these vines up means that they're less prone to frost. And we also are providing this canopy the way it's designed. This is basically a Watson system, which was developed in Texas. They are not grazing there, but they developed it mainly to get up and out of the humidity zone, and because they have a lot of fungal problems there. But for us, this is some of the unique things about this in this climate is that we're getting up higher, so we're reducing frost. It's cooling the canopy a bit because we're coming up higher. And we have this partial shade on both sides, which is shading the fruit, which is keeping the fruit cooler. This helps in the fact that climate is changing and it's getting warmer. And this is helping us to be resilient in the fact that things are warming up. So we've got the shade factor, we've got the light, We've got air that's flowing through here. We laid out these rows so the air comes right up the rows like this, and that helps us keep mildew, powdery mildew, away, reduce the incidence of that. And then we just have good air circulation in here, which is good for the health of the vines. In addition, the vineyard is set up so that the animals, because it's raised up, the animals can go either way in this vineyard. Most vineyards, basically, because you're trained lower, you can't access either direction. If you put animals in here, they got to stay in this section here. With this system, they can go any direction they want to. So that is helpful in being able to manage this four livestock in here. One of the things that we're also doing is keeping the ground covered throughout the year. That is not very common in a lot of vineyards now, but we are able to do that because, well, A, it's beneficial to the soil. We've never had to disc this vineyard, do any disturbance or anything like that. We do have to mow during the late spring before the vines are up tall enough, because we can't put sheep in here. But once the vines are tall enough, then we can run them in here for at any time of the year. So we're keeping the ground covered. We've eliminated all tillage. We've never had tillage in here, so I can't really say that we eliminated it, but we just don't do it as a practice. And we're encouraging native plants as well as cover crops and introduced species in here to increase the diversity, because we feel that diversity is important for soil health and ecosystem health too. We're not just looking at the health of the soil. The health of the soil is the basis of ecosystem health, but we're looking at other things above. We're looking at having healthy insect populations, which is indicated by things like spider webs all over the place. We're looking at diversity of plants. We're looking at bird species. We've created bird boxes that are all around the perimeter of the vineyard here for things like tree swallows and bluebirds. And so we're working on making this a really kind of fecund, alive, lively place. And so back to what is making this different. So instead of running tractor passes through here, tillage, cultivation, spraying herbicides, whatever, we're using livestock to do that. Livestock will also be doing suckering. We'll get shoots that come out of the lower parts of the vines. They eat that. They convert it to manure and urine. And so they're creating fertility out of the processes that used to pollute, things like herbicides, like fossil fuels. The animals are doing those things that were being done by machinery, and they're doing it free, and actually we're making money off of them. So we have a livestock enterprise too. So two things are happening in here. We have stacked enterprises. We've got the grapes and we've got the sheep. Maybe it's a bad year for grapes one year, but the livestock do well. So we've got all of these things going on that are contributing to the economics, the ecology, and then I didn't talk about the social aspects, but for me personally, and a lot of people, managing out here with sheep is a lot more fun than being on a tractor and sucking up exhaust all day. So it's a lot more humane way of managing things. So it's for me personally, it's a lot more fun and interesting too. Thanks for your time.